Weeping Willow 2 Daily Data News. Here's the second part of the video I did, uploading it on this channel.
Okay, then we shall go over here to Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Okay, folks. I'm going to stand my ground because I am against evil. And I know the word of the Father is true. And it shall not come nigh my dwelling. Because if this does happen, it would make his word a lie. And I cannot and will not fathom that. I can't. Mm-mm. So y'all stand by and, watch his hand at work. Because this is not going down. Mm-mm. All right, y'all. Have a good one. He paid the price for everything we could ever go through in this world. Everything. I mean, even though this is a depiction of the Father's Son, Yeshua, he suffered tremendously and paid the price for everything that we could even think of going through in this world. Y'all think that you suffer? Can you imagine having gone through and suffered what he went through? Mm-mm. Mm-mm. Those 6-inch-long thorns that were shoved between his flesh and his skull. He did this as a human. He gave up the spirit to go through this as you or I would have, had that been us. Having the flesh ripped from his skin or his bones. Suffering as you or I would have. He did that for us and for you. And you can recall, I'm sure everybody's had a splinter sometime or another. Just an itty bitty splinter in your finger or whatever that hurt like a dickens. Now, could you imagine all those thorns stuck, splinters, big splinters of thorns stuck between your scalp and your flesh? Your skull and your flesh. And that wasn't just for the 6 hours that he suffered on that cross. That was before he was ever put on the cross. They did it when he was in the prison. So yeah, think about that, y'all. Because he gave it all for you. Repent, repent, folks, because the hour is upon us. It is nigh. So, whether I have anybody or anything, stand up with me, as I've called out for a long time now in my videos.
As in a group.
But nobody will stand with me. I don't know what's happened to this country, other than evil is prevalent. It's just, people just don't care about people no more. I mean, you get all these false flag things going on, the Clive and Bundy bull, and that Colonel Riley up there in Washington, D.C. It's all bullshit. It was all bullshit. Just to divert your attention to that while the left hand's doing something over here, It was all bullshit. Now, I got sucked up into it. I had several videos on both of those issues. And I yanked them when I discovered that it was all false. I pulled those videos and put them on private because it was just a attention getter trying to stir up the people. But anyhow, people, you know, I realize a lot of people can't do anything and can't come the distance or anything where I am here in Owensboro, Kentucky. And J.P. Morgan Chase is evil that they're doing with no foundation. And the reason being because in the other court case that involved the same judge, Joe Caslin, and Jay Wethington and Daniel Berlew, all these three judges and the Kentucky State Attorney General, who is running for governor, by the way, a sworn liar, that none of these folks hold cotton to the oath of office that they swore to, which makes them Class D felons. That's a fact under federal law. And so, you know, and the county attorney, Claude Porter, the Commonwealth attorney, Bruce Kegel, the circuit court clerk, Susan Tierney, her son, which was in the other case, Matthew Tierney, who represents the asshole that stole my money, over $4,000, whereby I had asked in the complaint that he never bothered answering to till 65 or somewhere around that time frame. 65 days later, when civil rule called that within 20 days is supposed to answer the complaint or a default judgment may be taken out against you. Well, I filed for the default judgment, but the crooked judge is protecting the crooked thief and the crooked system and the crooked circuit court clerk, which they're all in cahoots with each other because it's a conspiracy and it is a coercion of fraud, protected the thief, that protected the frickin' brotherhood of the bar, the British Accredited Registry, that ended up protecting him, and screw me, you know. So they still have, over 2 years later, all of my money. That's self-enrichment, illegal. Okay, but who in this state's going to do a damn thing about it?
Over $48,000.
So, yeah, they plan on coming down here, and whatever's going to happen is going to happen, you know. And the Father be with me. And so, if things do go wrong, then my blood will be on their hands, and they will rot in hell for it. So, but I don't believe that's what's going to happen. But we'll see, won't we? Because I will stand against evil. I will stand and protect myself and my home. And, you know, that's just how it is. And whether anybody out there has got any gumption to stand up with me, hey, you're welcome to come on down. But I don't see that happening either. As long as the years that I've called out and tried to show people the truth, and put up the truth and showed the documents and all this, but nobody gives a shit. Nobody gives a shit. Nobody stands up for their neighbors anymore. You know, America's done gone down the tubes. You think it's going? No. It's already freaking gone.
Nobody's going to give a shit until it's their ass that's on the line.
You know, because, you know, what is that saying? I don't remember who said it. But all it takes for evil to reign is for good people to stand by and do nothing. And that's what everybody's done. They stand by and do nothing. That's why his country's in the sad sack shape that it's in. You know? It's what you call FUBAR. Okay? You military people out there know what I'm talking about when I say that. FUBAR. You know? But anywho, that's the crux of the issues, and there you have it.
Weeping Willow 2 for you. Weeping Willow 2. All right. Yeah, it grew to $48,000, and the crooked judge was protecting the crooked attorney, who is the son of the crooked court clerk, Susan Tierney, Matthew Tierney. It's all a family fucking bullshit up there. You know. Okay, there you have it. Bye. Carol?